Hi, my name is Marianne and I'm a master's student at Instituto Superior Técnico in Lisbon. Today, I'll be presenting the topic of my thesis, which is being developed at the Group of Theory and Modeling of Institute for Plasmas and Nuclear Fusion. But first, let's talk about nuclear fusion reactions. These reactions, that are the source of energy of the Sun, are the process of joining light nuclei to form heavier ones. As the final nuclei have a slightly smaller total mass than the sum of the initial ones, energy is released. The energy released in these reactions is substantial, so if we could control these reactions, we would have a powerful source of energy and meet the increasing demand. This source of energy would be clean, safe and sustainable as the nuclear fuels are abundant. But for fusion to occur, it is necessary to overcome the repulsive force between the positively charged nuclei. In the Sun, fusion is possible due to its high temperature and its gravity that keeps the fuels confined. On Earth, that's more complicated, as to overcome the repulsion and have fusion reactions, besides temperatures of millions of degrees Celsius, a confinement mechanism is needed. Temperatures, the nuclear fuels are completely ionized, forming a plasma. The most promising reaction under study is the fusion of two hydrogen isotopes, deuterium and tritium, giving a neutron and an alpha particle, which is an helium atom, both carrying kinetic energy. The resulting alpha particles are expected to be the main heating source of the plasma, by transferring energy to the other particles through collisions, thus allowing the plasma to stay at high temperatures without the need for external heating. One of the configurations under study in which these reactions would occur is the tokamak, which is a torus-shaped device. Inside the tokamak, both the nuclear fuels and alpha particles should be kept confined, so that the nuclear reactions keep occurring. As these are charged particles, their confinement can be accomplished by a magnetic field that is imposed using external coils. Now, in a plasma, there are waves propagating per parallel magnetic field, called Alphan waves, with a defined velocity called the Alphan speed. In projected future reactors, the fusion-borne alpha particles are expected to move at a speed close to the Alphan speed, and these particles may resonantly exchange energy with Alphan waves, perturbing the magnetic field used for confinement and raising the possibility of alpha particles moving away from the core and eventually reaching the reactor wall. But this cannot happen because, as I said before, alpha particles must be kept confined, so they heat the plasma and it's possible to achieve self-sustained nuclear fusion. Therefore, it is very important to study charged particle dynamics and its interaction with Alphan waves in a tokamak plasma. Computer simulations are used to compute the particle's trajectory under the influence of the background magnetic field, which upon a perturbation is superimposed. In an electromagnetic field, the particle's motion can be decomposed into two components: a fast gyro motion around the magnetic field lines and the slow motion of the center of this gyration, called the gyrocenter. In most cases, the fast motion can be ignored and the particle's trajectory is computed just for the gyrocenter, saving computational resources. But this is an approximation and can only be used when the magnetic field does not vary much along the particle fast gyration. For the background magnetic field that is used for confinement, this is typically a good approximation. However, when dealing with perturbations with spatial scales that are of the same order of magnitude of the radius of gyration of the particles, the approximation does not hold, and in that case, the full orbit of the particle, including the fast gyro motion, must be computed. As the transfer of energy between the particle and the wave must be evaluated, the properties of the energy evolution given by the algorithm are important and should be analyzed carefully. In my thesis, I will study, implement and test several orbit integration techniques to find out the one that best suits the problem. By applying the resulting full orbit code to a realistic nuclear reactor scenario, it should give a better understanding of the interaction between alpha particles and Alphan waves. This study is very important, as for achieving self-sustained nuclear fusion, we need to make sure that the alpha particles are kept confined.